Muralidharan, who is about to campaign in his constituency of Attingal, and we will get on with him on his truck to check just how he is feeling about this competition. This is a very tough three-way fight though, sir.
Yes, of course. It's a neck-to-neck fight, tri-cornered contest. But I hope to come out victorious after the at the end of the day.
All right, so let's get on to the truck. This is a constituency. The BJP increased its vote share by almost 15% last time around to 25%. What makes you confident this time around?
There are two aspects. I can say, maybe you can put it in three. First point is Prime Minister Narendra Modi going into his third term. That is for sure. And entire Kerala, people are convinced that Prime Minister Narendra Modi is going to have his third term once the election results are out and the new government gets formed. Second, there is a very, very, huge anti-incumbency against the present government. I'll not be expressing the real feelings when I say anti-incumbency. I will say there is a huge anger against the present government, which is steeped in corruption and violence.
But it's the Congress that has the most MPs from
that. That is what I'm saying. The third point in that is whether Congress will benefit or BJP will benefit. Congress is a divided house in Kerala. Congress is on the sunset path at the national level. So everyone in Kerala knows that, unlike last time, Rahul Gandhi is not going to be the Prime Minister. Rahul Gandhi will not be even an opposition leader. So, as Mamata Banerjee told, Congress will get 40 seats. With 40 seats, they will not become the leader of the opposition in the Lok Sabha. So, there is no point in electing an opposition MP to sit in the opposition benches and disrupt the parliament. So instead of that, people will definitely prefer to have an MP who will support the Prime Minister, and the benefits of Prime Minister Narendra Modi's development schemes and activities that it can be utilized by the constituents.
So just the bitter fight, there's a war of words going on between the CPM and the Congress here. Does that bitter fight help you?
No, this bitter fight and all is only an eyewash. Because the day before yesterday, Prakash Karat came and told that I am a well-wisher of Congress. So we don't want Congress to be finished. Their only grouse is Rahul Gandhi should not come and fight in Wayanad.
Right.
That is their only issue. Otherwise, they have no issue with Congress.
So, sir, I see anywhere you go, not just in Kerala, in the entire country, you're fighting on the flank of Narendra Modi's two terms, the deliverables of the Narendra Modi Sarkar. But in Kerala, apart from that, what is the issue on ground?
See, apart from that, other than Prime Minister Narendra Modi's achievements, I would say that Kerala needs development, especially my constituency. This constituency requires a lot of development, a lot of efforts in every front, whether it is infrastructure, jobs, agriculture, the situation of the tribal people. All these things are there, and the whole of Kerala, I would say that the largest number of people who go out from any state outside the state or outside the country, they are from Kerala. Kerala, in spite of the fact that people are literate, in spite of the fact that the climate is moderate, in spite of the fact that we have the nature has blessed Kerala, but it is not being utilized.
In the 2019 elections, BJP came close to the 25% vote share in this constituency, making it one of the prime seats being targeted this time around. The BJP increased its vote share by almost 15% in one election, and the party is hoping that it will see a further bump this time.
So you've also been a former BJP president in Kerala. Of course, you're a union minister, but I want to ask you, what do you make of the overall target the BJP has set? Very ambitious target in Kerala.
Of course, because if in Tripura it can go from zero to forming the government, why not in Kerala?
And Bengal is also a precedent.
Bengal is also, there are, see, it all takes till the election results are out, whether it was Bengal or Tripura. Nobody had anticipated such a result. So Kerala also can happen. All these things can happen in Kerala also.
How many seats?
No, I don't want to guess, make any guess. One thing is, there is still another 7 days. Things are going on well. There is nothing negative against Narendra Modi's government.
What will you say to critics who say that the BJP's politics doesn't work in Kerala? It doesn't work in Tamil Nadu, doesn't work in Kerala. The politics of Hindutva. For example, I remember you and I had spoken ahead of the 2021 state elections, and the BJP was fighting a lot on the plank of Sabrimala and love jihad. But those issues didn't quite translate into great votes for you.
We didn't fight on the plank of Sabrimala or love jihad. We fought on developmental issues. Others said that Sabrimala will favor us. Sabrimala favored Congress more. Not because of Congress stand regarding Sabrimala, but the people were so much against the left front, they want to teach them a lesson.
Yes, they lost
and,
some of their vote.
And then they felt that during the, that was in 2019, not 21.
Yes.
2019. So left front lost all the seats except one.
But what about the fact that these issues don't really resonate? Are these still the issues that you take to the public?
We have not taken, we take those also. Others shy away from issues which are closer to the heart of the majority community, the Hindu society. Others take up issues which are, maybe they feel they are, it is closer to the hearts of the minorities.
Right.
For us, we take up every issue related to the citizens of this country. That is why developmental issues we take the maximum.
And what do you make of the Christian vote bank? All three fronts are fighting for the Christian vote bank. They have voted both for the UDF and the LDF considerably in the past. Some has come to the BJP. I see some pockets and some churches announcing support to the BJP this time around. How do you see that Christian vote?
See, Christians are not against Narendra Modi or BJP as means the way they were earlier.
Okay.
So the distance have reduced. And I would say that we will get a sizable percentage of votes of the Christians.
All right. V. Muralidharan is at a pit stop, another one where he's going to be welcomed. He's going to meet some of the constituents and the workers as well. So we are going to try and interact with some more people down here as well, as the minister does that too. Is election mein sabse bada mudda kya hoga? Issue? What is big issue for you?
Big issue hai India ke famous. India a large country. India a bada country. A unity. A great unity. And great developing, world may number one. Country.
World may number one.
Country.
You want to see India number one in the world. Yes. Puri Vishw may number one. So who is going to do it?
After.
Who do you like? जो यहाँ से जो कैंडिडेट हैं वी मुरलीधरन अभी कैंपेन के लिए आए हैं
ये अच्छा कैंडिडेट है मुरलीधरन ये थ्री कैंडिडेट अच्छा है
सारे तीनों
अच्छा है ये भारतीय जनता पार्टी नेशनलिस्ट पार्टी कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी प्रादेशिक पार्टी स्टेट में कांग्रेस थोड़ा थोड़ा तीन चार स्टेट में उल्ली बाकी पूरा इंडिया में भारतीय जनता पार्टी अभी टाइम भारतीय जनता पार्टी में इंडिया में यूनिटी ग्रेट में।
विच पार्टी डू यू लाइक?
नरेंद्र मोदी की।
भारतीय जनता पार्टी?
भारतीय जनता पार्टी।
बिकॉज ऑफ नरेंद्र मोदी?
यस।
यू लाइक हिम?
आई लाइक हिम।
बिकॉज?
We as a family support BJP.
Last time, Congress's Adur Prakash beat a heavyweight left candidate to break their monopoly on the seat of almost three decades. But his vote percentage was the lowest for a winning candidate this seat has ever seen. And the margin of victory was also very tight. The repeat candidate of the UDF is not too worried though, confident that his work will speak for itself.
I am doing my job. That's why I don't have any worry about this result.
Yeah.
The people will always with me. I am always with people. That's my confidence. The last 29 years they are representing from here.
Yes.
29 years.
Yes.
After that I won.
Yes.
Yeah.
No,
this time also they are planning just like that, but we will fight against that.
Who do you think is your biggest competitor, the left Varkala MLA fighting from here or Union Minister V. Muralidharan? Who is the biggest competitor?
More
competition?
I am fighting with LDF.
Okay.
I am UDF, I am fighting with LDF.
BJP is not a factor?
No, that's not a problem.
So LDF and UDF, sir, your top leaders, likes of Rahul Gandhi, Priyanka Gandhi, are fighting with Pinaraya Vijayan every day. They are issuing statements against each other. What does that tell?
That's why I am saying I am also fighting against Pinaraya Vijayan. His policy, we can't able to accept his policy.
What policy, sir?
Policy means every time they are not giving the pension for the poor people. But they will get the money. His daughter will get the money every month.
So can Congress repeat 2019 performance?
Out of 2020, we will be.
20 this time.
Yeah, this time.
Modi bandu paranja guarantee alla.
Gas cylinders will be given by Rahul Gandhi. That's his guarantee. Not like Modi ki guarantee.
Rahul and the guarantee. Rahul Gandhi parayunu
ee kadanna varigeyana thingalinte prigin.
While the Congress and the left deny BJP is a factor in the fight, on ground their campaigns focus sufficiently on attacking the Modi model, making it clear that it is indeed Modi versus all. Whether the much touted Modi magic finally works in Kerala remains to be seen. With video journalist PS Rajesh, Shivani Gupta for CNN News 18.